The Territorial Police at Entebbe are investigating a fire outbreak that took place today at approximately 1 a.m. in Mulanda B, Kasubi. Upon receiving a distress call from the community member, the OC of Kasubi Police Station immediately responded. The fire had engulfed the residence of Bakita Ayang, a South Sudanese national, where six children were trapped despite efforts of community members to rescue them. The children aged between 2 and 16 succumbed to the fire. The Kasubi Police Station dispatched officers to the scene along with the firefighters from Entebbe Police Division. The fire was eventually extinguished and the bodies of the children retrieved and taken to the city mortuary for post-mortem. Police spokesperson for Kampala Metropolitan, Patrick Onyango, confirmed the incidents, saying that investigation into the likely cause of the fire is ongoing.
Abaana mukaga nga bonna bali wakati wa miaka 2 ne 10 na mukaga.
Initial observations suggest that the fire originated from an electric kettle left unattended to in a sitting room. Government has increased the charges for replacement of national IDs
from 50,000 to 300,000 Uganda shillings.
This follows the National Identification and Registration Authority revelation that many people are abusing the replacement of national IDs. The agency cited instances where public servants choose to amend their age so as to avoid the gazetted retirement age limit. Speaking to journalists at the media center today, the Minister for ICT and National Guidance, Dr. Chris Bariumusi, said that the cabinet came up with this decision as a measure of regulation. He, however, said there are exceptions, especially the marrieds who wish to amend their names.
Ebiri ku ID olusa abantu baleta ensonga ate mutozi matila muntu nagamba tijagala kuchusa olunaku wenazalibwa kati ensonga ngezo ezo tubadde tuchaji government ebadde charging emitwalo 5 na yezo kati tuzongeza kuja kuba musasura emitwalo 3 wobolese ensonga ngezo.
These changes take effect after the issuance of the new national IDs, which processes to commence next month this year. The Ministry of Works and Transport today distributed 28 tractors and road equipment to 14 districts that were not included in the previous allocation. During the commissioning of this equipment at the ministry headquarters in Kampala, the Prime Minister Robin Anabanja urged the district leaders to use this equipment to improve the livelihoods of the people.
Tukezako kulabanga engudo eza district zonna zibanga nungi nyo nkole bulungi ya dezataka menga abantu basobola okutwala ebirime byabwe mu katale, abaana bagenda ku masomero, abaana abalwadde bagenda ku malwaliro, n'abantu bafa aba bulijjo batambuza ebintu byabwe kinawadda.
The Minister for Works, General Katumba Wamala, cautioned the district leaders against misuse of these structures, saying that there is going to be adequate monitoring of this equipment.
Bawadde ko kitundu olw'obusobozi obwaliwo ebiseera ebyo ssente ze baliwo ne tusuubira neza sigalayo bilioni 3 oba 3 bajja zituwa na ziri components endala zijje nga wheel loader, I mean nga vibro roller ne tipa z'ebiri ne bauzo ya mazikwa ate bwokalakata notesaako mala munakunyiga ugundu teruguma.
The districts which received these graders and wheel loaders include Bugweri, Kalachi, Kapelepion, Karega, Kasanda, Kazo, Kwania, Kibube, Madiokolo, Nabilatu, Obongi, Rampara, Tereko and Chitagwenda. Government had distributed road construction equipment to districts across the country. However, the newly created districts had not received the same equipment, which had posed a challenge especially during the rainy season because the roads were in a poor state.